Good morning. I'm Darsha Pannambalam and you are listening Adavan News. Let's have a look at the highlights of today's newspaper. The main highlight of today's daily news says 500 million yuan Chinese bonanza. China made a 500 million yuan outright grant to Sri Lanka and said they would expedite the free trade agreement between the two countries to reduce the trade deficit. China also promised assistance for the second phase of the Hambantota Port project and cooperation to set up new industries. Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe held bilateral talks with his China's counterpart Li Keqiang at the Great Hall of the People's Republic China in Beijing yesterday. Speaking on the occasion, Chinese Prime Minister Li expressed his desire to help Sri Lanka, which is limping back to normalcy following a three-decade war with one of the most dangerous terrorist outfits in the world. Highlights at the middle says, policeman killed in train tipper collision. A policeman was killed and five others injured when a train collided with a tipper near the Vanavasala railway station yesterday morning. According to police, the tipper which tried to cross the rail track overlooking the railway signal at the level crossing collided with a Colombo-bound express power set train proceeding from Rambakkana. Another highlight says, largest heroin smuggling racket, 13 foreigners remanded. 13 suspects, including 10 Iranians and a Pakistani allegedly involved in the largest ever heroin smuggling in the sea, were yesterday ordered to be remanded until April 19th by the Colombo Fort Acting Magistrate. The Police Narcotics Bureau, with the assistance of the Sri Lanka Navy, seized 101 kilos of heroin on March 30th when the drugs were brought to Sri Lanka through the southern seas. The highlight at the middle says, Panama Papers revelation. Government to ascertain if any accusation made against Sri Lanka or Lankan personality. The government will do everything possible to find out if any accusation has been made against Sri Lanka or any Sri Lankan personality featured in the Panama Papers revelations and will investigate it in a transparent manner, State Enterprise Deputy Minister Eran Wickremaratne said. With that story, let's move to the highlights of Ceylon today. The main highlight says, Defence Secretary confirms Mahinda Rajapaksa and Gotabaya Rajapaksa's army security withdrawn. Special task force and police personnel with special VIP security training will henceforth comprise the security detail for Kurunagale District MP Mahinda Rajapaksa and former Defence Secretary Gotabaya Rajapaksa. The army personnel detail accorded to them hitherto will be withdrawn, Defence Secretary Harunasena Hediyaraji said. Highlights in the middle says, amnesty to return firearms. The Ministry of Defense announced yesterday that an amnesty has been declared from 25th of April to 5th of May to encourage the return of unlicensed firearms to the government. The Defense Ministry urged those in the possession of unlicensed weapons to surrender them before the amnesty period ends with no questions asked. Another highlight says, Code of Conduct for MPs tabled. A draft of the Code of Conduct prepared by Parliament to govern parliamentarians includes a prohibition on all MPs assaulting, harassing and intimidating another person. It was revealed in Parliament yesterday. There is other highlight says, Most Venerable Jnanaratna, new Askriya Chief Prelate. The Most Venerable Sri Jnanaratna Thero, the chief incumbent of the Badula Mudiyangana Raja Mahavihareya, was elected chief prelate of the Askriya chapter of the Chiam sect yesterday. The Most Venerable Sri Jnanaratna Thero becomes the 22nd chief prelate of the Askriya chapter of the Sri Dalada Maligaya in Kandy. The highlights at the bottom says, Joint opposition members appointed to COPE and COPA. Two members of the joint opposition have been appointed to the Committee on Public Enterprises and the Committee on Public Accounts. Deputy Speaker Tilanga Sumadipala announced in Parliament yesterday. MP Prasanna Ranadunga has been appointed to Committee on Public Enterprises, while MP Mahindananda has been appointed to Committee on Public Accounts. Another highlight says, Port City Motor Racing Track rejected. The government has decided to reject the laying of a motor racing track at the proposed Colombo Fort City project site. Government sources said it has also been decided to hand over space in the Port City project on a long-term lease instead of an outright sale basis. These decisions were announced to the media by Deputy Minister of State Enterprises Development Eran Wickremesinghe at the Post Cabinet Media briefing yesterday. Let's move to the highlights of Daily Mirror. The top highlight says, military personnel for Mahinda Rajapaksa and Gotabaya Rajapaksa will be replaced. Defense Secretary Karunasena Kediyaraji yesterday said that military personnel deployed for former President Mahinda Rajapaksa and former Defense Secretary Gotabaya Rajapaksa's security would be removed and replaced gradually, as deploying military personnel for VIP security is illegal. China to grant 500 million yuan to Sri Lanka. Prime Minister invite Chinese Premier for official visit next year. There is other highlight says, doors opened for more crossovers. Government. The government formally informed Parliament yesterday that there were as many as 92 ministers, deputy ministers and state ministers, and doors were opened to accommodate further crossovers from the opposition to increase the number if necessary. Another highlight says, I was wrong to leave UNP to join CBK. Former Minister Mervyn Silva yesterday said that he regretted his decision to leave the United National Party after receiving an invitation to join the SLFE by ex-president Chandrika Kumaratunga. He said he would have embarked on a fine journey with Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe if he hadn't left the party. He claimed to have played a major role in electing the Jagapalaniya government but said today he was left with nothing. Highlight in the middle says, Prisifec notice not delivered to Pasil's wife. Former Economic Development Minister Pasil Rajapaksa's wife Puspa, who was summoned by the Presidential Commission of Inquiry to investigate and inquire into serious acts of fraud, corruption and abuse of power, state resource and privileges, did not appear before the commission yesterday as the notice could not be delivered to her. A spokesman for the commission said, the highlight at the bottom says, produce owner of 1000cc bike in court. Deputy Mass Media and Parliamentary Affairs Minister Karunaratna Paranavidhana yesterday said the police must immediately arrest and produce before courts the owner of the 1000cc high-powered motorbike that allegedly hid from behind a jeep belonging to the Mega Police and Western Development Ministry at Rajagiriya on the night of February 28. That's all for today's newspaper highlights, and join us tomorrow too. Thank you.